Here we want to solve the given trig equation on the interval from 0 to 2 pi. It looks like a pretty straightforward equation, so let's go ahead and isolate the cosine function by subtracting 0.85 on both sides. This will be 0. So we have cosine x equals negative 0.85. So we want to determine the angles on this interval that have a cosine function value of negative 0.85. Remember, on the unit circle, cosine theta is equal to x, and the x-coordinate is negative in the second and third quadrants. So the angles that are solutions to this equation must have terminal sides in the second and third quadrants. And that's important because we need to make sure that we determine all of the solutions in this interval. And having a cosine function value of negative 0.85 is not going to result in a nice reference angle or reference triangle. So we'll have to use the calculator to help us solve this equation. So if we take the inverse cosine of both sides of the equation, we can solve this for x. So the left side simplifies nicely to x, and on the right side we have inverse cosine of negative 0.85. So now we'll go to the calculator to help us determine one of the solutions to this equation. Let's start by making sure that we're in radian mode. You can see here in the third row we are. So now we'll press second cosine, negative 0.85, or just negative 0.85. And so one of the solutions on the given interval is when x is approximately 2.587 radians. Well, we know half a revolution counterclockwise is pi radians, or approximately 3.14 radians. So this angle has a terminal side in the second quadrant. Let's say it's somewhere here. And again, this is approximately 2.587 radians. Well, in order to determine the angle in the third quadrant that has the same cosine function value, we'll have to determine the reference angle of this first solution. So this angle here, let's call it alpha, would be pi radians minus 2.587 radians. And I've already determined the measure of that angle. It's approximately 0.555 radians. So if this angle is 0.55 radians, then the solution that has a terminal side in the third quadrant would have the same reference angle. So it would look something like this, where again this angle here is 0.55 radians. So now we need to determine what the measure of the second angle would be. It would start here and rotate to here. Well, that would be pi radians plus approximately 0.55 radians. So the second solution is going to be approximately pi plus 0.55 radians. Which gives us approximately, which is equal to approximately 3.697 radians. And let's just go ahead and just verify these solutions. We can do it pretty easily by just typing in cosine 2.587. Should be approximately negative 0.85. And it is. Notice off a little bit because we did round. And then also cosine 3.697. And again, it looks good.